فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون
People of the Sufi ideology justify visiting the shrines for intercession by the verse, those who die in the way of Allah are not dead, they are living with their Lord. They claim that their saints hear the supplication and intercede.
Actually, this verse is a strong proof against those grave worshippers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying about the martyrs that they are with him. Okay, عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. Okay, and this shows that they are in paradise, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained. عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ, that they are in paradise. And that they are not only in paradise, their souls will be installed into the hearts of small birds. And those birds will be flying in paradise wherever they want. So this is against a proof against them. They are not aware of you. They are in paradise, enjoying paradise. And someone who is in paradise, enjoying it, what does he need to go back to the misery that he was in this life? And also, it's not up to them. Their souls are held there. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the book about the dead people, he said that he holds their soul with him. وَيُمْسِكُ الَّتِي قَضَى عَلَيْهَا بِالْمَوْتِ عِنْدَهِ. Yumsik means he holds them. While those Sufis claim, as I read in their books, that after death, their souls will be absolutely free, and they can go wherever they want, and they can recognize whatever they want, they can see what they want, they can do what they want. Their answers, their calls would be answered. They're such and such. This is false imagination that they have made up, which has no basis in the Book of Allah, and not only have no basis, but the proofs are all against it. Like the verse about holding the souls, it's very clear. How could Allah say, I hold those souls with me, and then you come here and claim that the souls are free and they go wherever they want? Who are you? Are you another Lord besides Allah? Allah is saying He is holding the souls. And you come and claim that they are free everywhere and they do what they want. This is misleading. And this is cheating the people. Actually, those so-called Sufi sheikhs and those people, they want to be like the Christian priests. They want sources of living. They want money to come to them. They want power. They want, authority over people. So they tell them, no, don't make dua except through us. Don't make repentance except through us. This is Christianity. This is not Islam. In Islam, you don't do this. You see, in Islam, you free the person from all kinds of slavery and make him only a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's it. And this is the meaning of Islam. You see? So those people, actually, they are worse than Christians and worse than Jews, actually.
Will one be held responsible if he finds people seeking intercession from the dead, but he is not able to stop them?
No, a person will only be held about something which is within his ability. Allah says it clear in Quran, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. The Prophet ﷺ said, a prophet would come on the day of judgment with no followers at all. You see, he couldn't, he couldn't guide anyone. Okay, the guidance is up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He did his best. No one followed him. You see, and he is a prophet of Allah. So you do your best. If you can give da'wah in a gentle way, in a nice way, and bring them back to the right path, that's good. That's your duty. You should do it. as much as you can. If not, you be concerned of yourself. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا عَلَيْكُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ مَنْ ضَلَّ إِذَا اهْتَدَيْتُمْ. Oh, you have faith, be aware of yourselves. Take care of yourselves. Do not be affected by the misguidance of those who go astray. And this verse applies in situations like this, where you find yourself helpless. You cannot do anything. No one is listening. Everyone is turning his back. Okay. So I don't waste time with them. You see, I don't waste time with them. As the Prophet ﷺ explained this verse, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, he said, حَتَّى إِذَا رَأَيْتَ شُحًّا مُطَاعًا وَهَوًا مُتَّبَعًا وَاتِّبَاعِ كُلِّ ذِي رَأْيٍ لِرَأْيِهِ فَدَعْ عَنْكَ أَمْرَ الْعَامَّةِ وَعَلَيْكَ بِخَاصَّةِ نَفْسِكَ. That when you see the situation comes to this, where people don't want to listen to you, to the truth, everyone wants to follow what he thinks is right, and so on, then be aware of yourself only and take care of yourself only and let aside the what concerns those people. You don't have anything to do with them. Okay? So this is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the religion of Allah based on realism, not based on emotions and things like that, you know. It's based on realism. When the people in Mecca in the beginning of Islam, when they were little in number, they were outnumbered by not only the number of people, by everything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them to tie their hands and not to fight and just to establish the prayer. Okay? Why? Because Allah is so merciful. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ بِكُمْ رَحِيمًا. Okay? Now. Nah.